Hey, what's up, guys? Today we're going to be reacting to Kendrick Lamar's new album, Mr. Morale and the Big Steppers. This is his last album with Top Dog Entertainment. He references Top Dog in multiple of his songs. Whoever thought the greatest rapper would be from coincidence? Because if Anthony killed Dougie, Top Dog could be serving life while I grow up without a father and die in a gunfight. So much so that Top Dog becomes a character instead of just a label. Kendrick is known for telling really good stories. Two examples of this is the song Sing About Me and Black Boy Fly. People say this album is a hard listen, but I found it had more replayability than most of the albums that came in the last 5 years that Kendrick was gone. Let's get into the album.
Hey, K-Dot.
Yeah, yeah.
Can we get it how we used to get it, like when Top had the red charger? Can we get it how we used to get it, like when Top had the red charger?
In 5 years, a lot of things have changed. Kendrick is kind of tired of having to address all of it. He basically is saying that he doesn't want the crown anymore. He's saying that all the responsibility that comes with it is difficult to handle, as well as it being super confusing. I've been social gimmicks, I've been ducking the overnight activist. Yeah, I'm not a trending topic, I'm a hold on, y'all niggas playing with. Kendrick is that rapper to talk about specific worldly events. He's done so with songs like All Right in a time of racial tension and police brutality in America. The song All Right became like a national anthem for protests in America. He actually made that song when he visited South Africa and he saw how difficult people lived. He doesn't feel the need to say something because it's just an everyday thing. It's nothing new to him. A really good song on this album is called Father Time. Most people like this one. It just talks about male toxicity and how a lot of men grew up with absentee fathers. I love my father for telling me to take off the gloves, cause everything he didn't want was everything I was. Until my partners that figured it out without a father, I salute you, may your blessings be neutral to your toddlers. You learn things about being a man, being tough and getting through stuff. Albeit that's really good advice, sometimes it comes to the detriment of men, and I feel like it's not talked about in the manosphere. Therapy is mentioned a lot throughout this album, and it's something that a lot of men just duck. They have like the boys to talk to, and usually that's kind of surface level. People just say, hey man, just run up your money and you'll be fine. When you have like really deep childhood issues and problems, therapist usually is the case you have to go to, albeit therapy is expensive. He talked about his transgender aunt in the song Auntie Diary. He's basically saying, if you can't say the F word, then no one can really say the N word or something like that. It was a really weird half apology type of thing. I get where he's coming from. It's a little confusing to understand. That's a whole nother subject than whether or not people should say the N word. Completely different conversation to have. It comes down to it. Kendrick basically dethroned himself. He realized that he can't be everyone's savior. Kendrick in the beginning had this belief that he was going to be the savior of hip hop. You can see in an album like Damn, where he kind of puts himself on a high pedestal, especially the pictures that he's given on a big table like The Last Supper, and now he's seeing the detriment to that. Like, you can't solve everyone's problem, especially in this day and age where everybody would rather be outraged than to understand each other. There's no point of really trying to make everybody happy. Anyways, guys, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time.